what owning a Nintendo console is like? Because I'll tell you what owning a Nintendo console is like right now, okay? So just imagine this scenario, okay? Imagine, like, let's just say, you've been searching for a job for months in some dead-end town that everybody would have moved out of the second they graduated from college or got an offer or something to move out of town. And here you are still living in this dead-end town with your parents. Anyhow, you finally get a job somewhere, okay? You finally get a call from somebody saying, hey, we got your resume, we'd like to do an interview. And unlike the past 10 times where they ended the interview saying, we'll call you back later, okay? And never calling you back, or sending you an email saying, after carefully reviewing your application, we've decided to pursue other opportunities or candidates or whatever the fuck they're using. And this time, unlike those times where you were told that, they're telling you, oh, great, you're hired. You do the whole, it depends on who the place is. You might be doing the whole background check and all that stuff. But here's what happens, okay? I'm gonna tell you what happens. So, like, you get to this job, and what happens is, you find out it's a complete shit show. Sometimes right away, sometimes over time, but oftentimes you'll learn not long after you started why you got the job there, okay? Maybe it's because it's in a bad part of town, or because their boss has a hair trigger and will flip shit at any single thing, or maybe they aren't paying you on time. Maybe they're taking forever to pay you, even though your car has gas, and even though you're down to $6 in your bank account, because you don't have money for gas and other things. You can only pay for gas, and that's about it, really, because guess what? They didn't pay you on time. They waited months and months to pay you. Whoops. And hey, these are what happens when you get a shitty job. Eventually, you get fired, and it's kind of a mixed thing, because on one hand, you're like, thank fucking God, I'm done with this shithole. But then you look at your bank account, and you're like, oh, I need money, whoops. Maybe I should become an Amazon Flex driver or some shit. And that's the thing. That's what Nintendo consoles are like. It's like you're getting fucked in the ass over and over and over and over again with these shittiest jobs in the city. That's what Nintendo systems are like, okay? You get fucked over and over and over again all the damn time. It's ridiculous. It really is. And that's the thing. Just like how people stay with shitty-ass jobs because they need money, people still buy Nintendo products because they need that brand name. I mean, Nintendo is like the fat neckbeard version of Apple or Jordans or Mercedes-Benz and Tesla cars and that kind of stuff. They're status symbols, except instead of being for rich people, they're for nerds living in their mom's basement who are like, oh yeah, I'm real gamers. I'm a real gamer. I play video games for kids, and I wanna fucking jerk off to Pokemon and Star Fox. That's what they're like, okay? But the thing with Nintendo is, while their games might be the game console company of choice for neckbeards in their mom's basement and stuff, the thing with Nintendo is, their consoles are fucking garbage, okay? Here's the thing, I actually did buy another Wii U for a short period of time to resell. I did resell it for maybe slightly more than what I paid for it. Not as much as I would have gotten, considering how Amazon has become a complete shit show to sell anything on, and Amazon was where you could sell stuff for higher prices than eBay. But the thing is, I bought it because I thought maybe this would be a good idea to resell. I mean, you know, sometimes people do that kind of stuff, especially me. I mean, I'll buy stuff and then I'll resell all the time. And the thing is, the Nintendo Wii U was such a piece of shit console, okay? I decided before I sell it, I would do a few reviews of games that nerds online kept telling me to review, especially Breath of the Wild. They were playing nerds like, hey, Gligar, review Breath of the Wild, okay? So I did. I got a used Wii U from a pawn shop cheap, and I used it to review some games. Holy shit, I forgot how bad the Wii U was. It is the slowest system ever, okay? It's like as fast as a Chinese piece of shit Android tablet or some Acer laptop bogged down with Windows 10. That is what Nintendo Wii U is like OS-wise. It is fucking slow. It is so goddamn slow. You tap something, you're waiting for it to do its damn thing. It takes forever to do anything on this system. Holy shit. It is such a bad system. And the graphics on there suck, okay? Not Wii games. The graphics suck because the system was underpowered. Didn't have an Ethernet port. You had to use its shitty, weak, and underpowered Wi-Fi instead. But the best part, oh yeah, the best part about the Wii U is its controller sucked. Its range sucked. Its battery life sucked harder. And the battery was provisioned, the battery area was provisioned, so you could put a bigger battery in it because they deliberately put an underpowered battery in there, so you have to shell out more money to Nintendo to get the extended life battery. But that's not the best part! Oh no! The best part is the range sucks ass! It really does! You had the fucking ads for the system showing people playing this thing everywhere. But you know what happened when you actually owned the system? You were having to pick the system up and put it places too. You have to carry the system with you because it didn't have enough range to go anywhere. I mean, you'd go to another room, you shut the door, bam, the connection drops. You'd move further away in a bigger room, bam, the connection drops. You'd want to play it in your room at night, you have to move the system up to your room too. You want to play it in the toilet? Same shit. Because the thing is, like, okay, I'll give the Switch credit. At least it does this better because it's a full portable system, even if it has other compromises, like the system also being underpowered yet again. But there is one good thing about the freaking, there is one good thing about the Switch. That's what it is. The Wii U, on the other hand, it had this shitty, fragile controller. It broke a lot. It was hard to get replaced. And the best part about this whole fucking piece of shit controller is that when it broke, you couldn't just get another one. You had to fix it yourself. You had to call Nintendo up and have them, you had to pay them, $125 or some shit to replace the controller. And Nintendo's service department isn't exactly the best, too. And that's the thing, I'm not gonna buy a Nintendo Switch, especially after, Nintendo's consoles just aren't that great, okay? They really are. Everybody hypes them up because, oh my god, they're Nintendo! But, what the fuck's the point of buying a Switch when it doesn't have games? Because guess what? The Switch has no games. It has even less games than the Wii U launched with that are worth playing. You look at the Nintendo Switch aisle in a game store, it's fucking desolate as fuck. There are no games. But everybody is hyped up over it because it says Nintendo on it. And that means, oh my god, I gotta run out and purchase a new Nintendo system! Because that's what the Switch is like, okay, people? That is what Nintendo Switch is like, okay? What is the point in buying a Nintendo Switch when it's gonna be the same old shit as a Wii U? In fact, I know somebody with a Switch. They had issues with the controller not working when it got back from support. They opened it up, saw Nintendo's repairs, shitty-ass soldering job. Nintendo's like, oh, whoops, you gotta buy a new Wii U, you gotta buy a new Switch. You gotta buy a new Nintendo Switch because you opened up the controller and now it's warranty's ruined. Whoops. That's what happened with a friend. He found out the soldering job for the battery was shit. Because he had to get his controller fixed. and they had to send it in and stuff. And they sent him back a broken controller. And he wanted to get a replacement Joy-Con because he had the colored one. And guess what? Because Nintendo wasn't producing enough of the fucker, he couldn't get a matching one. But that's what Nintendo is. They can produce limited supplies of their systems, and Nintendo fans will worship Nintendo for this. They'll defend Nintendo. They're like, oh no, it's that darn scalper. Well, guess who's driving a BMW i8 to pick up more Switches on launch day? It's not the guy in the beat-up Saturn or the 1997 Chevy Lumina. It's the guy in the nice car, because he's the guy who knows shit about business and how to make money. And Nintendo, on the other hand, they're feeding this by not producing enough. So here's the deal. If the Wii U is such a piece of shit system, why should I assume that the Switch is going to be any better? Why should I? I'm not the kind of person who wastes money on shit. I guess I'm not. Anyhow, thanks for watching and subscribe for more, and please, don't waste your money on Nintendo systems, because let's be honest here, what the fuck is the point of it?